Chandrayaan 1 was carried by Mark 2. Now this is being carried by Mark 3. But the idea is very interesting. Idea is, we want to establish, we can manage a mission of this nature. We can reach the lunar surface. We can drop and soft land on the surface of the moon.
Chandrayaan 1 is over, Mangalyaan is over. Now we are in the doorsteps of Chandrayaan 2. How do you compare these two? Like, I heard you saying there is not much of a difference other than crash landing and soft landing. But development wise?
No, I think it is more or less the same. As I told you that up to the orbiter, it is the same. The only difference is Chandrayaan 1 was carried by Mark 2. Now this is being carried by Mark 3. Now this Mark 3, if it were available during the Chandrayaan 1, you would have gone with the Mark 3. Uh-huh. Okay. Now its non-availability is the only reason why we went ahead with the Mark 2, and we limited our requirement to the crash landing. Uh-huh. So this is something, you know, you play around with what you have. So that's how it we went. And then the Mark 3 is available now, it can carry higher weight. Though, you know, it has a capability of 3.5 tons. Finally, the so-called meaningful part of it is the rover. Now the rover is so small, about 28 kg or something like that. And it has a limited life. But the idea is very interesting. Idea is, we want to establish, we can manage a mission of this nature. We can reach the lunar surface. We can drop and soft land on the surface of the moon. And we can also make an object to move and then do some little bit of jugglery there. And that will establish our ability to have the communication and, you know, that kind of thing. So that is actually a very interesting mission. So the real suspense starts only on September 6th, 7th. By that time, you will be ready to drop it.